Hi, my name's William, and I want to make a video at an advanced level on riding bicycles, and I want to ask questions to people, especially from the Maldives and Bhutan, and explain a little bit about my experience riding bikes in the United States and other countries. Because this is an advanced video, it's going to be faster, and the sentences longer, the grammar and vocabulary harder, but the ideas are going to be very similar to the other two videos. You can use those two videos to help you understand this one. So I like to ride bikes. When I say bikes, I mean bicycle, not motorbikes. And I learned how to ride when maybe I was 8 years old. I wasn't very good at that. I wasn't good at sports. My sister learned before me, and my dad wanted me to learn. And I learned in a small town in America that was very flat, but we found a hill, a small hill. And that's easier to learn because you go faster. I learned when I was 8, and then maybe the last 20 years, I've been a big bike rider, both in Chicago, the city where I live, and also in Boston, also in Florida, and then in other countries where I've lived and worked, most recently the past 2 years in Bangladesh, before that in Vietnam, especially the southern part of Vietnam called the Mekong Delta. And one thing that runs through lots of these is the geography. Chicago, Florida, the Mekong Delta, Bangladesh are really flat places, some of the flattest places in the world. And if you like to ride bicycles, maybe flat places are boring, but they're really nice and easy because you don't have to work hard going up a hill and it's not scary going down a hill. So right now I live in Chittagong, a city of 6 million people, the metropolitan area. The city proper is smaller, just 2.5. But still, really, the city is 6 million people, and it's very, very crowded, which means riding inside the city is possible, but not pleasurable. That's a frustration. The place in Vietnam that I lived was a small village of maybe 30 to 50,000 people, a small city. And it was never more than 4 or 5 blocks to get to a village. As a biker, that was fantastic. I could be on my bike, and in 2 minutes, 3 minutes, I would be in some place with rice fields, paddy fields, butterflies, trees. It was gorgeous, very easy to get to, and flat. In Bangladesh, I can also find villages like that, but it takes me longer to find them. From where I live, I have to bike 30 or 40 minutes through crowded, noisy, polluted streets. That's frustrating. But after that, I'm in some place that's much quieter. There's 3 or 4 villages nearby that I often bike in, and I also will often go to the area near the Bay of Bengal, a sea or ocean. And even though that is maybe part of the city, it's not very crowded. There's a special road there that really has no trucks or cars. It's mostly a dirt road, and sometimes there's a car, but usually it's just maybe a CNG or a rickshaw, cows, fishermen, and me riding my bicycle. It's a fantastic place because to the west I can see mangrove trees and the water, and I can see boats that the fishermen use. It's a great place to go riding my bike. So what I would like to know a little bit, especially for those people who are living in Bhutan and the Maldives, what is your experience with bicycles there? I've chosen these two countries for, I think, the same reason. I think of all the countries in SAARC, in South Asia, your two countries maybe are the most unusual for riding bikes. Why? Well, the Bhutan is really mountainous. It's a small country in the Himalayas, beautiful, wonderful, but I think it's a hard place to ride a bike because in my imagination, it's always uphill or downhill. In my imagination, you have to work extremely hard to pedal uphill, even if you shift your gear down. And going down, you're always going to be pressing those brakes because you don't want to go out of control and go over the side. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know, but I want you to make a video and tell me. There might be flat places, or maybe Bhutanese people are just really strong and will ride their bikes even in the mountains. I don't know. The Maldives is a different case. You're flat, just like Chittagong, just like Bangladesh, like Chicago, like Florida, like the Mekong Delta in Vietnam. That's fantastic for a bike rider. But the Maldives is made up of lots of separate islands. That's not a problem, but it just means I think that the islands are 1 or 2 kilometers long. And because of that, it's really hard to go ride a long, long place. So I would like you to maybe make a short video and discuss your experience of riding bikes. Do people ride bikes in the Maldives? Is there a lot of traffic? Can you put your bike on a ferry and go to another island? I have no idea, but you have an idea and you can explain this to us. So for especially people from the Maldives and Bhutan, I want this to be an invitation for you to make a video, ideally, and explain this to us. You could be like what I'm doing now and just making a video, and it's an amateur video. Somebody might come in the room, that's okay. We're not professionals. You could make an audio if you don't want to make a video. Sit in front of your computer and just make an audio file. You could take photographs and put those together and then talk over that if you like. I don't know. But I would like you, though, to think of how you could make something to explain, especially to other people in South Asia, what it's like to ride a bike in Bhutan and the Maldives. Thank you.